Director Recruiting. Melanie Abbott, ITN, Worcester.
There's a wide range of stories in the Sunday papers this morning, but following the controversial scientific advances in cloning and embryology of recent weeks, two titles lead with medical matters. The Sunday Telegraph picks up on the offer by Cardinal Winning, the leader of Scotland's Roman Catholics, to pay church money to women who cancel plans to have an abortion. The paper says the pledge is the launch of a new pre-election campaign designed to increase pressure on pro-choice MPs. The Sunday Times claims that in the light of the technology used to produce Dolly the sheep, doctors believe they've already produced the world's first human clone, a four-year-old boy who's living in Belgium. With the general election now just weeks away, The Independent on Sunday reveals details of what it says is a blueprint for a dirty election, revealing that the Tories are employing controversial Australian spin doctors to help their campaign. Splashed across the Observer's front page is a picture of a 10-year-old boy whose hardened criminal exploits, it says, could bring about a change in the law, presenting a direct challenge to the legal notion that children are exempt from the law because they don't know the difference between right and wrong. And finally, The Express on Sunday has a picture exclusive of Thomas McMahon, Lord Mountbatten's IRA killer, on day release from prison at a building site in Dublin. It's now 19 minutes to six. You're watching the morning news from ITN. Coming up, misery for Damon Hill as David Coulthard wins the Australian Grand Prix. Join us again after the break.
The television set you're watching right now. Find out if you could change it for a brand new one like this and still pay less. Phone DVR free on 0800 599 599 now. You can have this new 20-inch remote-controlled colour television for only £5.99 a month. And there are many more in the range for immediate delivery. Phone free on 0800 599 599 now or see Teletext page 662. DVR, the best buy.
Smoking, ask your pharmacist. Nicorette. Enjoy life without cigarettes.
Welcome back to ITN's Morning News. Today's top story. Pressure is growing this morning for doctors to be tested regularly to screen out those carrying the AIDS virus. It comes as thousands of women continue to call a special helpline after the discovery of another doctor with HIV. Now our review, a look back at some of the main stories of the week as reported on ITN. The government's plans for a radical overhaul of old age pensions received a mixed reception. The new scheme will only affect first-time voters and those who are younger still. This from our political editor, Michael Brunson.
To the government and many other people besides, there is a basic problem about pensions, and it is this, that with people living longer, there are more and more and more pensioners.
There is for any government another problem. Britain has no state old age pension fund. Both the present old age pension and the extra state pension scheme, SERPs, are simply paid out from the money the government gets in each year from taxes and national insurance contributions. So more and more pensioners create a bigger and bigger bill. Under the new Basic Pensions Plus plan, everyone will have to open their own private pension fund, managed by a firm of their choice. While everyone will still pay national insurance while working, the government will ensure that at least £9 of that national insurance payment will be invested per week in the funds. After a lifetime's employment, someone on average earnings should have £130,000 invested in their fund, enough to pay out a pension of £175 per week. For those who can't afford things, there'll be a safety net for the poor and unemployed. But the Labour Party called in the cameras to denounce the scheme. It's privatisation, they said, and Tory promises to underwrite it are, like all their promises, worthless. And from the former Labour Cabinet Minister who brought in SERPs, this angry summary.
This is simply a recipe to increase insecurity and poverty in old age, to widen the gap in our society, which has been so so blatant. The widening gap. You're all right, brother, if you're well off.
The Liberal Democrats, too, voiced their grave concern.
I feel that we've got to keep the universal basic state pension. That is something I've fought for many years now, and I will carry on fighting for it.
But in No. 10 Downing Street, the Prime Minister said that that and more is exactly what the new scheme would deliver, but in a far more efficient and effective way.
It's a reform that will mean the British people will be able to look forward to retirement with even greater confidence in future. And it offers for our young people a pensions opportunity that quite literally will be unrivaled anywhere else in the world.
And other Conservatives are saying that as an example of a radical solution to a 21st century problem, the new pension scheme is a vote-winning big idea.
A jury at Winchester Crown Court couldn't agree a verdict on any of the corruption charges faced by Bruce Grobbelaar, John Fashanu, Hans Segers and a Malaysian businessman. All four denied conspiring to fix the results of football matches. ITN's Robert Hall sent this report from Winchester.
They had waited 11 hours for a verdict. The charges against them remain in place. Bruce Grobbelaar, John Fashanu, Hans Segers and Heng Xuan Lim are at the centre of allegations that rocked British soccer. But after considering 32 days of detailed evidence, jurors could not return a verdict on even a single charge. Faced with such deadlock, the judge, Mr. Justice Tuckey, said he had no alternative but to discharge them. Defence teams expressing their frustration and disappointment.
Everybody, I think, connected with the case, and of course particularly the defendants, who've been under such enormous pressure for such a long period of time, and Bruce for the longest of all, they all wanted finality.
When he leaves home in the morning to say goodbye to his children, he's not quite sure where he's going to see them in the evening. And that pressure is unbearable and relentless, and he may not have to do it again.
The match-fixing allegations arose after an elaborate sting operation in this Southampton hotel. The conversations, recorded on hidden cameras, were to form a crucial part of the prosecution case and lead Hampshire detectives down one of the most complex trails they had ever followed. To support conspiracy charges, the inquiry team amassed thousands of documents, hundreds of witness statements, and a web of contacts traced through the mobile phone network. The defence found their proof on the pitch, claiming these pictures showed that even the best made mistakes. Those accused of the conspiracy had never let the national sport down. In the end, with costs running well over £1 million, defendants and media are still waiting.
The judge has made it clear that he expects any decision on a retrial to be taken as quickly as possible. The Attorney General and the Crown Prosecution Service will have to decide whether it's in the public interest to go through the whole process again. If not, the four defendants will return here to be formally acquitted. They and their legal teams have been told to expect a final decision within 10 days.
300,000 households were told to boil their water in case it was contaminated by an organism which causes stomach upsets. The bug's been linked to 32 cases of illness. This from our health editor, Lawrence McGinty.
No, I've just got diarrhoea. You have got a headache.
Thousands of worried customers in Hertfordshire and North London have phoned the hotline set up to reassure them about the cryptosporidium outbreak.
We have already advised our customers to boil the water, and we've sent out notices to every one of the customers within the affected area, and at the same time we have taken all the necessary precautions at our works.
Many customers are following that advice to boil water, although it's only a precaution, because it's not clear yet that the outbreak was caused by water contamination. Only three samples contain cryptosporidium, and at low levels.
Well, unfortunately, we can't get rid of it completely. It's in the environment. There's no way we'll ever get rid of it. It's in farm animals, it's in domestic animals, it's even in some human beings. But what we try and do is keep it out of the water supply.
Cryptosporidium occurs in sheep, cows, and household pets. It can be passed on by touching the animals and then handling food with contaminated hands. And it can get into water supplies through farm slurry and runoffs. It's not a bacterium, but a microscopic parasite that causes about 5,000 cases a year of mild diarrhea and tummy upsets. The last big outbreak happened 2 years ago in Torbay in South Devon, when 600 people were affected. The infection was traced to this waterworks.
The water inspectorate here at the Department of the Environment is bringing a case against South West Water because of that outbreak. It's due to be heard in the courts in September. Cryptosporidium infections may not be on the increase, but awareness of them certainly is.
Today's sport now, and there have been extraordinary scenes at the Australian Grand Prix in Melbourne. First, world champion Damon Hill's car packed up on the warm-up lap. Then the race favourite Jacques Villeneuve span off on the first corner. Minutes before the end of the race, his Williams teammate Heinz-Harald Frentzen came off with brake problems. It left the way open to David Coulthard in a McLaren to clinch victory. From the track, here's Steve Scott.
World champion Damon Hill knew he was never going to catch the leaders from the back of the grid. What he was looking for from his new car was reliability. He didn't get it. An electrical fault on the warm-up lap meant Hill sensationally couldn't even start the race. More drama quickly followed at the first corner. Favourite and the man in pole position, Jacques Villeneuve, was bundled off the track. The Williams challenge was then taken up by Hill's replacement this year, Heinz-Harald Frentzen, but a disastrous pit stop gave Scotland's David Coulthard in his McLaren Mercedes a clear lead, a lead that Coulthard kept right through to the chequered flag, all that time stopping Michael Schumacher from passing him, Coulthard running a near-perfect race for his second Formula One win. Jackie Stewart's new team, Stewart Ford, had a good day in their first Grand Prix. No points, but both cars almost finished the race, an incredible feat considering the team was nothing more than an idea barely a year ago. But the afternoon was Coulthard's. Britain's Damon Hill will relinquish his title this year. Who's to say now another Brit won't be there at the end of the season to take his crown? Steve Scott, ITN, Melbourne.
Soccer, and there are three FA Cup sixth-round ties this afternoon. All involved are looking to join Middlesbrough in the semi-finals. Here with the rest of the sports news is Graham Miller.
Middlesbrough may be struggling in the Premiership, but they're still on course for a cup double. Brazilian star Juninho put Brian Robson's side 1-0 up at Derby, and he set up the second for another foreign import, Fabrizio Ravanelli, who sealed this FA Cup sixth-round tie, Middlesbrough through to the semi-finals for the first time. Meanwhile, Manchester United's successful week in Europe was ruined by struggling Sunderland in the Premiership. Michael Gray got Sunderland's first goal to end a run of four straight defeats and renew their hopes for survival. Dennis Bergkamp scored twice for Arsenal in their win over Forest at Highbury. So United's first defeat for 4 months means their lead at the top has been cut to 3 points by Arsenal. Liverpool meet Newcastle on Monday. Bolton moved one step closer to Premiership football with a 7-0 trouncing of Swindon. Alan Thompson set the ball rolling with Bolton's first after Nathan Blake had done the hard part. Bolton have now scored 80 league goals so far. One surprise in Scotland, with First Division Falkirk going through to the Tenants' Cup quarter-finals at the expense of Premier Division Wraith. Elsewhere, the FA are to hold an investigation into a pitch invasion at Brighton. It happened after Scott McLeish put Orient 4-3 ahead and celebrated in some style. Several fans ran on. One made a furious attack on Orient's former England captain, Ray Wilkins. Wilkins was unhurt. Four men were arrested. Brighton recently failed with an appeal to win back 2 points following a pitch invasion last October. Aisha Hansen won Britain's first medal at the World Indoor Athletics Championships in Paris. Her 14.7-metre triple jump earned her a silver medal and set a new British record. Ireland's Sonia O'Sullivan went on to win silver in the 3,000 metres.
You're watching the morning news from ITN. It's 7 minutes to six on Sunday, the 9th of March. Here's a reminder of today's top stories. Pressure is growing this morning for doctors to be tested regularly to screen out those carrying the AIDS virus. It comes as thousands of women continue to call a special helpline after the discovery of another doctor with HIV. He is to appear before a General Medical Council disciplinary committee tomorrow. Sir James Goldsmith is urging more Tory Euro rebels to follow Sir George Gardner's decision to defect to the referendum party. Sir George, the deselected Tory MP, has announced he's now the referendum party's first Member of Parliament. To add to Tory woes, the Eurosceptic MP Theresa Gorman said if she were a voter in his Reigate constituency, she would be very tempted to vote for him. The royal family will gather at St George's Chapel in Windsor this afternoon for Prince William's confirmation. The service will be conducted by the Bishop of London and not, as is usual with heirs to the throne, by the Archbishop of Canterbury. Dr. Carey says he doesn't regard it as a snub. 15 ticket holders share a jackpot of £8.3 million in last night's National Lottery draw. The winning numbers are 5, 12, 20, 29, 39, 42. The bonus number is 22. The winning tickets will each receive £550,000. And finally, skygazers in China have been enjoying a rare cosmic double, witnessing a total solar eclipse that coincided with a comet. The sky went dark and temperatures dropped to minus 25 degrees Celsius as the moon blocked the sun's rays for more than 2 minutes at the northern tip of China's border with Russia. It happened at the same time as the arrival of the Hale-Bopp comet, named after the two amateur astronomers who discovered it in 1995. And that's all from the ITN Morning News team. Next on ITV is GMTV. The next main news from ITN will be at 1 o'clock. Meanwhile, from all of us here, goodbye.
Snowball, shirts and snowboards, massive amounts of Sprite and snowboarding lessons at the Big Air Party Weekend. Obey your thirst, Sprite.
In my job, I've got to make sure every part of the costume is perfect. That means the right accessories, the right look. I even do the washing, and on a film set, that's pretty tough. The lights will show up, dirty marks on white, much more. You can't get away with anything. Collars and cuffs are the areas that get the most damage, I call it. And you've got lights which make you hotter. So something that would take normally a day in real life get very dirty in the space of 2 or 3 hours. Sometimes the job would be just too tough for normal washing powder. So I'd have to use an extra stain remover as well. But this new rollerball from Ariel's changed all that.
Ariel Future Liquid now has a revolutionary new rollerball cleaning system. First, it drives the Ariel Liquid deep into some of the most difficult stains, then goes in to leave all your washing deep down clean.
Now I'm more confident it'll look pristine first take. Perfect, like it's meant to be.
When you demand the impeccable, demand Ariel.
Creating a recipe for a new vegetarian soup is a delicate business. You must be careful to bring out the fresh flavors. And you have to keep experimenting with new ingredients. Of course, it does help when your family has been creating soups for over 125 years. Broccoli soup with fromage frais from Baxter's, the family of fine foods.
Some gum problems can leave you exposed to the pain of sensitive teeth. Sensodyne F is proven to relieve that pain. And now that it contains the antibacterial agent triclosan, everyday brushing fights plaque and helps keep gums healthy, giving complete protection to your teeth and your gums. For sensitive teeth, Sensodyne F fights pain, tooth decay, and now helps fight gum disease.
Got a kitchen. Got a pan. Got vegetables. Got a pan. Got a sweet and sour meal maker. Blah, blah. Just add chicken, pork or vegetables. Got a generous meal for two. Chop. Add meal maker, simmer and serve.
one-pan meal makers from Cross and Blackwell. Now there's a thought. What would you say to a Cadbury's mini roll?
Yummy!
Cadbury's mini rolls.
Deck out Sunday evening on Channel 3 North East with Play Your Cards Right.
A nursing sister?
Yeah.
Oh, not a good name for a nurse, is it?
Darling.
Drop into the Rovers at 7:30, then a classic tale of love and passion, Jane Eyre.
He made me love him without even realising it.
At 10 past 10, Clive James.
Tom Cruise, The Spice Girls, Rory McGrath, Lily Savage, Margarita Prakatan. Think of a show with all those names, call it the...